Howdy, Space Rangers, Captain Phoenix here. You know, Russia should just stick to wars. It's the only thing they're good at. Have you ever seen a movie that's so bad that you can't help but laugh and comment on everything it does? Have you ever seen a movie that made you want to bleach your eyes, then gouge them out? No, seriously, I had to watch something good after this atrocity. I had to watch like Madagascar 3, Megamind, it was a mess. Well, this movie did that for me. Pinocchio, a true story, is a movie I've been looking forward to for a long time. Ever since the trailer came out, really. Ever since the trailer came out, I knew it'd be good. In fact, I even made a YouTube poop of it on my second channel. You can go check it out if you want. I think I'll even leave the link in the description. But back to this. This movie is so bad in all the wrong ways. It does not make sense. It lies to you. And most importantly, it looks ugly. So, come with me as I review this piece of trash, sorry excuse for a movie. Seriously, aside from turning red, all the movies that have come out this year so far have been hot garbage doo-doo water. 2022, are you okay?
Literal doo-doo water?
But, on the bright side, this movie does have a child getting shot and human trafficking, so it's bound to be at least somewhat interesting. Number one, the animation. Normally when I talk about a movie, I talk about its story first. But today, I'm going to change it up a bit, for good reason. The animation is the most glaring thing wrong with this movie, as it is what the audience is looking at, obviously, for all of the movie. And it is the biggest of my many, 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 many problems with the movie. This movie was made by Cinema Fund Russia, which is of course a Russian studio. And this movie has almost no budget, and it shows. It must have gone to all the war effort, huh? You know what's funny? The Disney Pinocchio movie also came out during a war, so I guess history really is repeating itself. The animation looks dull. The colors they use don't bounce off the screen, nor do they look bright and inviting. They look like they were just plastered there to make the movie easier to digest. I mean, just look at this city shot! There is nothing unique about this. Look, everything just looks so lifeless. What is that pier? Oh my god. The textures look completely different from each other or just don't line up properly. This makes the blending look ugly and disgusting. Sometimes the characters just seem like they're not in the same world and don't even make contact with it, let alone the ground. Look at this! The character is not touching the ground, they're just like sliding over it! Speaking of the characters, some of their rigs look nothing short of horrifying. Most notably, Geppetto. He looks like he's from another universe altogether. He doesn't look like he's a part of this movie. This looks like a creature from an alternate dimension. The detective's movements are too much. They're too bouncy and cartoony. It's all over the place. It absolutely looks ridiculous. And yes, I know how weird that sounds. How does something that exists in a cartoon look too cartoony? Just look at this guy. What the hell? The detective's assistants are just the twins from The Shining. What horror movie is this? And Pinocchio's human face is just...
Okay. Oh my god! What's wrong with your face?
What the living hell was that?
Fire!
Like, you know it's bad when his puppet design is more human than his human one. And his puppet design is just a human face with like slight wooden textures, like with the little wood spirals in there. Why is this movie? In fact, the animation is so bad that here are all of the animation errors I caught on my first viewing alone. I know there are a bunch more, but here are the ones I found. For one, the model of Lucilda's horse here is the exact same horse that belongs to Bella later on. Look, it's the exact same horse! They didn't even bother to like give her a different shade of coloring or change her mane. They just gave it the same model. Really? That is just lazy right there. The animation sequences for Pinocchio doing his aerobatics on the horse are repeated without any change. So no change whatsoever. Again, showing how lazy they were when it came to just using the same animation over and over. The animation of the frog fountain here spitting into the water causes no ripple effects, but in the exact next scene, they do cause ripple effects, so showing that these are just water sticks. Pinocchio's reflection can also not be that clear with the ripples. Like, if you're gonna ignore water physics with the fountain, you could at least pay attention to the water physics with the reflection. In the scene where Bella is singing in her carriage, from the outside, the curtains are closed, but when we look inside, The curtain is wide open. And no, she did not open it. I will rewind it for you. He has the curtain closed. And here is it still open. I mean, open all of a sudden. What happened? It turns from night to day in a single scene with no transition. We just expect the clouds to part or the fog, and it's all of a sudden day. The night is still in the background. In the scene where Pinocchio is getting robbed, he just teleports onto the horse's back after tripping the cat. What the heck? Also, because no one said it, KKK cat. Yeah, I said it. And this isn't an animation error so much as it is an editing one. But at the end of the movie, Bella runs into the tent crying. But we still hear her afterward, and the characters act so nonchalantly about it. It's like it doesn't even matter. It's also as if someone really wanted that extra crying to be there during their conversation. Which is like, what? And she didn't even go into the tent. We later see crying to the horse in the open.
Truth all along.
What the heck was that? What is that off-screen cry? How would they even hear it if she's in the tent? This movie breaks your brain cells. There are only a few instances in the movie where it seemed that there was an effort put into the animation, though there are a few. I guess the scenes where Pinocchio is performing in the circus do have some life to them. Same goes with Bella and all her circus scenes and songs. Surprisingly watchable. Can I also just say that Bella's hair is way too animated. That thing is always flowing seamlessly when she's on screen. You can tell this is where all the animation budget went to, because it doesn't even look horrendous. It honestly reminds me of this anime, Love is War, where that girl's dance has too much budget and effort put into it, or at least that's the meme I hear. One last thing I need to comment on the animation is the dubbing. Because this movie was made in Russia, they needed to get English translators for the international audiences. And let me just say, the lip syncing and voice acting are laughable at best. But we'll get into that later. For now, let's focus on number two, the story. Let me just get this out of the way, alright? Let me just say it right now so that I don't end up repeating it in the original blah 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 for the rest of the video, make it redundant and make you guys annoyed with me. So, right away, the movie punches its audience in the face by saying this movie will not have the elements of the classic Pinocchio story that we all know, but instead will be something different.
People started making up some silly stories about growing noses and whatnot. Tell me. Have you ever seen a nose grow right in front of you?
Have you ever seen a wooden puppet come to life in front of you at all? No, I don't think so. It's a fairy tale, goddammit. I don't think they're meant to be the most realistic thing in history. But let's compare the elements in the original story and what this movie changed for the sake of it. So 1, Tybalt the horse is Pinocchio's companion instead of Jiminy Cricket. 2, Pinocchio's nose does not grow at all in this movie, as clearly stated. 3, Pinocchio has a love interest. 4, the belly of the whale scene is replaced with Pinocchio and Geppetto being captured and put in a cage. And 5, instead of it being Pinocchio's love for his father that turns him into a real boy, it's his true love for a random girl he met a week ago and was barely with throughout the movie. So, yeah, now that we got that out of the way, let's move on with the horrendous story. The story is about Pinocchio wanting to explore the world, and he does so by traveling with a circus. When he joins the circus, he meets a girl named Bella. After meeting Bella, he proceeds to give up on exploring the world and puts everything on the line to attain her love. He then goes on another journey of finding the fairy lady Lucilda to ask her to turn him into a real boy while avoiding crooks and cops who want to capture or arrest him or kill him. Before I complain about the story, let me just say that I love how Pinocchio meets the circus guys.
My greetings, sir.
Mamma mia! A wooden boy!
Oh, that felt so good. Can I see it again, please? One more time. Alright, just one more just to get out my system and for good measure. Okay, I think we can go home and happy now. Now that I've gotten that out of my system, the story does not make any sense. It feels like they took as many story elements as possible and tried to shove them in to see what sticks. Like, they're throwing it on the wall and they're like, does that work? Does that work? Ah, doesn't matter. Put it in the film. Most of these subplots don't even go anywhere. The movie feels like a 5-second section story where the storyteller is like telling you all 5 parts, but they forgot to tell you part 3. And so by the time you get to like the end of part 5, they're like, oh, by the way, in part 3, this and this happened. And it's very clunky. They do not know how to tell the story well in this. The storytelling is very bad. A lot of arcs don't even go anywhere. Or just aren't told well. For example, Pinocchio did not have to go all the way to meet Lucilda. It has been shown throughout the movie that she can teleport. And at will, she can teleport at will and appear to those in desperate need for help. This whole subplot was filler because not only could it have been shorter, but when he does go to see her, she tells him to F off and figure out how to be a real boy on his own. Why didn't she just teleport to him and tell him that earlier instead of wasting our time? My time specifically. Also, how did a small parrot move all those rocks? And there's a scene in the movie where Pinocchio is like running through the gorge and the parrot's like pushing a bunch of rocks. How does it do that? Maybe this is the work of evil spirits. And on top of that, there was another scene where the cat and the fox tried to rob Pinocchio. And the cat and the fox really had no reason to rob Pinocchio, as he never once uses his money in the film. In fact, I think the film even forgot Pinocchio had money. And so it just makes that whole scene pointless. And on top of that, the cat wears his KKK mask also. Also, because no one said it again, KKK cat. Also, towards the end of the film, Tybalt leaves Pinocchio alone for no reason, and even though his explanation for why is just so crap. And anyway, even if he gives that explanation, it's not given till like the very end of the movie, and it's done so in a way like if you blink, you miss it. Like if you close your ears for 1 second, you'll even miss why he left Pinocchio like that. Other plot lines that also came out of freaking nowhere are the twist of the circus crew are the thieves. That doesn't make sense if you think about it even for a second. For one, they were still with Pinocchio when he did his performance in the beginning of the film. Look, there he is. There's the ringleader during Pinocchio's performance. Oh my gosh, how did they get there? And why do they both need and want to get rid of Pinocchio? Like, the ringleader, the circus leader, he wants to keep Pinocchio because Pinocchio brings him money and he keeps the crowd more busy so he can go rob people. But the cat and fox don't want Pinocchio to be around because he's too altruistic, or like he's one-upping them. And I'm like, isn't that the whole point? Isn't the whole point for Pinocchio to be better than you guys so that you guys make your act bad on purpose so you can go rob people? Why do you want to get Pinocchio lost? Why do you want to have him killed? Why do you want him out of the circus if he's gonna be more beneficial to you? And why does Pinocchio even stay at the circus? Dude could leave literally at any time and they would not stop him. They also claim that he's like staying for Bella, but like right after Bella rejects him, he has no reason to stay. He goes on his mission to like find Lucilda, but then when he's coming back, he's like, oh, I gotta go save Bella. No, bro, just go home. Just go home at that point. And towards the end of the movie, we get another plot twist with Bella and the detective, being that Bella is the detective's daughter. This honestly feels so forced to me, because it came out of nowhere. And it's as if it was desperately shoehorned in there so that the writers didn't have to make Bella related to the circus master, to the circus leader. They're like, oh crap, Bella's a good person. How about we just have her not be related to the circus leader? Which doesn't make any sense at all, because like she could still be related to him, but she could be a good person. We've had stories where children turn on their parents before, guys. Like, this is in the 80s or whatever. Oh yeah, and this is the scene where we finally learn that human trafficking exists in the Pinocchio universe.
Tell me the truth, and it will be used in your favor during the trial.
Will it now? Very well then. I'll tell you the truth. I never found you. I just bought you, little girl, from someone who kidnapped. I'll tell you the truth. I never found you. I just bought you, little girl, from someone who kidnapped you from your parents.
Also, you gotta love how she immediately hugs her father, who she doesn't remember. Mind you, she grew up without this guy and she just immediately runs into his arms.
My father.
Yes, your mother will be so happy to see you.
Bro, I'm not saying he looks like one, but I am saying you don't know him. Dude could be an abusive father. That's all I'm saying. And back to Pinocchio. Dude literally doesn't have to stay. He told Geppetto he would come back after one show. Pinocchio decides to stay for a bunch of shows. Okay, fair enough. But then he says he'll go back home immediately if things go south. What do you know? Things went south. Bella rejected him and his co-workers are being mean to him. Pinocchio has no, like, obligation to stay. He could go home. He goes to find out how to become a boy and then he's like, okay, fine. I'll go home now. Then he finds out that Bella could be involved in a crime scheme. But he knows very well that Bella's father is the crime lord. So it wouldn't be a stretch to assume that Bella probably knows. But no, he decides to go back for Bella. Again, dude, you could just go home. The circus dudes, by going home, you would even be putting the circus dudes at a disadvantage. They need you to make the circus work. Before, they only had Bella and thus only had very limited time to rob people. With you, you extended their time. So by you leaving, you would be actually doing things. You'd be saving the day. I have never seen a movie where the simplest solution was go home. And I'm not talking about those movies where we have to get back home because we're lost. I mean a movie where the character is actually doing something and just vibing. I have never seen the simplest solution be go home. Just go home and the movie can end. So yeah, suffice to say, the story doesn't make sense, it's inconsistent, and it's just flat out bad. Number 3, the writing. When writing a story, it's important to note that you should try and capture the essence of your story and the identity of your characters and why they make the choices they do. This movie has none of that. From the cringing dialogue such as,
"Father, when can I leave to be on my own? I've got the whole world to see.
Venture.
I did want to see the world, but I realized she is the most beautiful thing the world has to offer.
Did you seriously think that you and Bella
miracles are priceless?
That went straight over my tongue.
Gotcha. You've only seen my good side, but now you'll see my bad side.
Not to mention they're just some.
You know who your parents are? Here they are in these woods. An oak and a maple. Huh. No wonder you're like hanging out in the woods so much. You're as smart as a log."
Not to mention there are just some other scenes that are so horribly inconsistent. For example, at the beginning of the movie, how did Tybalt not meet Lucilda? Or at least see what she looks like, considering he was right there when she brought Pinocchio to life. This scene I'm showing you, they were both in this scene. My God. This movie had not just one, but two third act breakups. This one with Tybalt and Pinocchio, and later on with Bella. How do you have two third act breakups? That is the dumbest thing I've seen. And mind you, he made up with Tybalt. Like, they actually gave him time to make up with Tybalt after like 2 minutes of them being separated. But for Bella, they just make up off screen. Like, these guys become friends off screen. We don't even see that relationship bloom. I swear to God, Pinocchio actually has more chemistry with the horse than Bella, his love interest. Also, how did Geppetto find Pinocchio if not even the cops could find him? Like, I was thinking that maybe he found him through the posters, but the cops used the posters and they couldn't find Pinocchio no matter which town he was in. So Geppetto really should be the one who's hired to be like the chief of police or something. Dude was able to find his son before the police could. So there we go. Another thing I find annoying is that the cops straight up don't shoot Tybalt, even though they said they would, and they had ample time to. He's a horse, you guys have guns. Bullets are faster than horses. So yeah, the writing in this movie is at best bland and at worst painful to sit through and listen. And now we get to talk about the characters and their voices. We finally get to talk about the worst aspect of this movie. Now, granted, I will admit that it was the voice of Pinocchio that made me interested in watching this movie. His weird, fruity father sounding like a 16-year-old Brooklyn girl, that made me want to watch this movie. When I watched this movie, however, it's as if they changed his voice actor. It's as if they changed some voice actors. I probably didn't get the American version or the Lionsgate version, so that's probably why I don't hear Tom Kenny in this movie. But regardless, I'm still going to talk about the voices I heard. So let's start off with Pinocchio. Pinocchio as a character is a hot mess. The movie doesn't know if he should be naive, wise beyond his years, arrogant, adventurous, or all of them. He's whatever the movie wants him to be. And that is just sad and lazy character writing, as he doesn't even seem to have a consistent leg to stand on, let alone a wooden one. And his voice is better than in the trailers, however, only marginally. It's like a 0.5% difference. At least in the trailers, his voice was fun to listen to, him sounding like some weird teenage girl. In the movie, he just sounds like an actual puppet. "Father, I wanna go see the world." He doesn't have that edge to him like in the trailer where he's like, "Father, I wanna go see the world." And that really does kind of take a lot out of the movie. Seeing as the reason I watched the movie is for the voice, I did kind of feel let down, and the movie obviously got a lot more boring. And a lot of characters did get changed their voices for. Even Tybalt the horse and Geppetto didn't get Tom Kenny. But for some reason, the fox and the cat kept the same voices. Like, the fox and the cat from the trailer is the same voice for, like, in the movie. So I don't know why they had to change the main characters but not the side characters. Again, I probably didn't get the American version, so that's probably on my bad, on my side.
Father, when can I leave to be on my own? I've got the whole world to see.
That's the voice I have to deal with. So, that's the voice I don't get to deal with, sadly enough. I can't even make fun of it because it's not in the movie. So while the voice in the movie I got was better, at least professionally, you can't exactly make fun of it. So, it's sad. Next, we have Tybalt the horse. And Tybalt is the most annoying character I have ever seen. He might just be the most annoying character of all media, period. He sucks as a babysitter. Constantly belittles Pinocchio over every little thing, yet he also shows his incompetency throughout the movie in great abundance. He is not funny, and most of all, his voice drives me up the wall. He's like, oh, Pinocchio, don't listen to me. I am your father, Pinocchio. Puppets don't grow their noses. Shut the hell up. You have made deaf people here and then want to go back to being deaf. All right, Tybalt, in all honesty, should have his legs broken, be put down with a bullet to the head, boiled alive while still barely conscious. He still has some bit of life left in him. I didn't turn into horse glue, which I can buy at my local store. I hate this guy so much, and I hate the fact that he's one of the main characters. Next, we have the villains, the fox, the cat, and the circus leader. The fox and the cat are fine. Their voices are funny. I really enjoyed laughing at them, especially that cat being like,
"Hello? Did you seriously think that you and Bella?"
That gets me every time. Legit, that is gold. If I can't get the Pinocchio voice from the trailer, I can at least sell with that. As for the villains and their motivation, I've said it before. It doesn't make sense that they're robbers. And even if they are robbers, I don't know why they're so intent on just making Pinocchio as upset as possible when they kind of need him for their plans. It just is very dumb. This is the dumbest villain writing I've seen. And the twist, like at the middle of the movie, just doesn't make sense. Again, it's a mess. These guys as villains, they're probably the worst written part of this movie. Then we have Bella herself, the blue-haired girl, who just has nice hair. Everyone else gets stiff animation. Bella is even more wooden than Pinocchio. She sings and cries whenever she's not poorly being voice acted, and everything she does is for Pinocchio, and she always needs to be saved by him. She's your typical damsel in distress, I swear to God. Her voice is not only I don't think it's intentional, but her voice always sounds condescending, like she's trying to talk down to you. Pinocchio, you'll be a star one day, don't you? Oh, yes, you do. Oh, yes, you do want to be a star. Of course you do. It just sounds wrong. So her voice just doesn't sound right. It sounds awful. It sounds condescending. And she's a damsel in distress. People want to talk about poorly written women characters? Check out this female character. Where the SJWs on this movie? Geppetto is fine. His voice is okay. He sounds like the warm old grandpa, old father thing. I don't mind it. Though I do find it weird he went to go look for Pinocchio. Like, why? Why? You didn't know Pinocchio was in trouble. Yeah, maybe you had a feeling, but you didn't straight up know. You didn't have no facts, and you didn't even know where he was. If Lucilda came up to you and told you that, hey, Pinocchio's in trouble, I would buy it. But the fact that you just go off based on a feeling, that is the dumbest thing ever. He said he was gonna be home. He said he was gonna come back if things went south. And on top of that, the circus can't really hold him in. Yeah, they kept him in a cage, but the minute they released him, he could just grab Tybalt and go. And he's made of wood. They can't kill him unless they use fire. Bullets are ineffective against him. The movie has pointed this out time and time again. I don't know why Geppetto is so worried for Pinocchio's safety. Dude literally cannot die except at the end of the movie. Then we have Lucilda and the detective, who don't have enough character to make them work or to give them enough flair, so I can't really critique them. I'll just put them under the category of useless. Though it does make me wonder, why the hell did the detective really become a detective? Because in the movie he says, I became a detective not to catch criminals, but to find my daughter. And I'm like, okay, so you were looking for your daughter. You felt bad that your daughter was gone, and that's why you became a detective, to one day track her down. But the way he came to that epiphany, it sounds as if he just discovered why he became a detective for the first time. It's not as if like this is his life's work for the past 11 years. Like, oh yeah, I'm a detective, so I can hopefully one day find my daughter. I'm trying to like attribute to my sins for not taking care of her enough. No. I just realized I became a detective to find my daughter. Ain't that kooky? Oh my gosh, you could have seen this coming. Especially not me. I'm the one who chose the career, but I'm not the one who went to go look for my daughter. Oh my gosh. I find it so weird I went to go look for my daughter. It's just, what the hell? Bro, what the hell? It's so weird. And then he becomes a new circus master. So it was his real passion wanting to be a circus master, but he wanted to look for his daughter instead, so he became a detective. Bro, you could look for your daughter and become a circus master. You can do both at once. You don't have to straight up be a detective. That's just anime. That's just anime logic right there. But whatever. Whatever. So yeah, the characters are all bad. The voice acting is literal
doo-doo water.
All of them just do not deliver the voice as well. Lucilda sounds like those soapy, sappy people you find on the cards. She's literally every like lovey-dovey greeting card you'd find in the story. Always believe in tomorrow. Miracles are for free. Oh my god, I am Lucilda. It's like, no. She's literally just a walking card. Geppetto, as I mentioned, his voice wasn't too horrible. But the detective's voice, as I mentioned, he's just way, way too cartoony. So, yeah. The voice acting is... And none of them are enjoyable enough to sit through the movie with. So, in conclusion, that's it. In conclusion, Pinocchio, A True Story is a film that lies to you. It is not based on any real events. There were no real talking puppets back then. No fairies and no magic. And can you believe it? No talking animals. What? Oh my gosh, I didn't see that coming. It does not have a good story with an emotional center. It does not have good animation, nor does it have sympathetic characters. What Pinocchio, A True Story is a bad movie that shouldn't even be classified as a movie. This thing is an insult to not just its source material, not just the fans of the source material, not just animation in general, but an insult to all of media. Pinocchio, A True Story is one of the worst movies I have ever seen, and because it's so bad I couldn't enjoy it, I give it a 1 out of 10. I hope you lose the war, Russia. This film budget or its profits or whatever money it's making for you, they're not gonna do much for your murder efforts. But anyways, guys, that's my review of Pinocchio, A True Story. Please don't watch it. Stay as far away from it as a growing nose can. If you have seen it, sadly, though, however, let me know in the comments. What did you think of it? Am I being too exaggerated and harsh on it? Or am I spot on? Let me know and I'll read your thoughts. I do genuinely appreciate every comment that counts my way, and I would love to hear your thoughts. But anyway, guys, that's it from me. Like if you like, subscribe if you haven't already, hit the notification bell to be part of the team, slap a cow, and with that, I have been Captain Phoenix, and I will see you in another universe. Goodbye, my Rangers. Love you all.